Good morning. This is Jennifer King, ABC News anchor, reporting live from Antioch Baptist Church, Christmas Eve 2020. We invite you to come take a walk through Bethlehem with us as we try to catch up to some of the people who were there the very first Christmas Eve. Our roving reporter, Tara Robinson, is on the scene. Tara, are you there?
Yes, Jennifer, thank you. This is Tara Robinson reporting live for ABC News on location. So excited. It is the very first Christmas Eve. We are in a nearby field just outside of Bethlehem. Let's see who we can find to talk to. I saw a young woman earlier. Oh, look, I think that's Mary. Mary, hi. Tara Robinson with Antioch Baptist News. How was your trip from Nazareth?
It was long and hard and sometimes dangerous. We knew it would be, but the law said that we had to come. Sometimes I felt frightened, but then I would remember what the angel said to me. Don't be afraid, Mary. I didn't understand all that the angels had said to me, that I was chosen to bear God's son, me. But now I know that truly nothing is impossible with God. Yes, the trip was long and hard, but Joseph has been so brave. He brought us safely here all the way to Bethlehem. Where is he? We're both so tired. I hope he's found a place where we can rest.
I hope so, too. I know you both have to be exhausted.
Yeah. Oh, I think I see him.
Joseph. Hi, Joseph. Tara Robinson with ABC News. Do you have just a minute to talk with us?
Just for a minute. I need to get to Mary. This has not been easy for her. We've just arrived here from Nazareth.
Nazareth, is that your hometown?
Yes, Mary and I are both from Nazareth. It's a small village about 90 miles north of here. We have family and many friends there. It's a good place to raise our family. They're kind people, but it didn't take long for word to spread. I understand the looks, the judgment, and their disappointment, but I could not abandon Mary to them. Even in those first moments when I was aware something was amiss, I knew it couldn't be Mary. Whatever else happened, she didn't deserve that punishment. I would not put her through the public humiliation. That was before the dream, before the angel spoke his name, Jesus, before my world turned upside down. And now, see the task, the blessing. I have to go. Mary needs me. This baby needs me. I will be his shelter. I give my word.
How could it be? This baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully, the Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? Lord, I know he's not my own, not of my flesh, not of my bone. Still, Father, let this baby be the son of my love. Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be Father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? He looks so small, his face and hands so fair. And when he cries, the sun just seems to disappear. But when he laughs, it shines again. How could it be? Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man Father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? How could it be? This baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully, the Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? How could it be?
She's very blessed to have you, Joseph. Safe travels.
Welcome back to ABC News. This is Jennifer King. This just in. Someone reported they saw shepherds heading this direction into the city. Tara, have you been able to speak to any of them?
Yes, Jennifer. I believe I see some shepherds now. Hey, you girls! Are you girls real shepherds? Are you headed into Bethlehem?
We are real shepherds. We work on our father's farm.
I love working in the fields. It gives me plenty of time to relax and lots of quiet time.
You mean lazy and daydreaming?
So what brings y'all into town tonight?
You won't believe it. Earlier tonight we was in town and all of a sudden we spotted this really big, beautiful stars when all of a sudden angels appeared right before our very eyes.
This angel came out of nowhere and said, "Be not afraid."
Next thing we know, the whole sky became one bright light.
We were almost blinded. It was angels. They were everywhere. It was indescribable.
Wow, how about that? Real angels. What did they say? What did they want?
They said a Savior had been born in the city of David. He's right here in Bethlehem. They're announcing the birth of the Messiah.
And we're on our way to see him. I will never forget this night. I'm telling everyone I know. You must come see this child too.
Well, this really isn't the best night for me. I have this show and all.
I would drop everything if that was you. This is a once-in-a-lifetime deal. I wish you could have seen the angels. They were everywhere.
Wow. I really, really wish I was going with them. Hi, Jennifer. I am going to need to go into town and find out some more on this developing story. So, that is all for now. This is Tara Robinson, ABC News Live on location. Back to you, Jennifer.
While waiting, let's do a recap. We've seen Mary and Joseph speaking about the birth of God's Son. We've seen shepherds talking about a star and angels and a Messiah and a manger. I believe Tara has made it to the city. Let's get back to her.
Excuse me, sir, ma'am. Do you own this inn?
Yes, we do.
I hear that you are completely booked, and earlier today you had to turn away a young couple from Nazareth?
Yes, we did. But business is good, even too good. Every room is occupied, some even doubled up. But I've never seen traffic like this in Bethlehem.
The reason we are swamped with visitors is because of that Caesar Augustus. He is making everyone return to this place to be counted and registered. They're calling it a census. We are so sorry that we did not have a room for that young couple. We learned that he is a carpenter from Nazareth. His name is Joseph, and he walked here leading a donkey carrying his pregnant wife. He said that her time is close, and he begged us for help.
I tried to tell him there was no room in the inn, but they just keep begging for a place to stay, and I was hesitant to tell him about the stable out back, but they just kept begging for a place to stay.
She was so young and weary from the long trip. I know that her time is coming soon. I hope that she's okay.
Something tells me that this child is going to change the world.